This is Tim Bryce with my column titled 2017 Year-End Wrap-Up. This is my last column for the year as I prepare to enjoy the holidays and rest up for 2018. As has become customary, I'm using this opportunity to review my top essays from the past year. As you know, I write on a variety of subjects such as management, systems, technology, social issues, politics, and observations of our changing world. Sometimes my work is instructional and informative. Other times it is controversial or humorous. I certainly hope it isn't boring. By the number of subscribers I have, their comments, and the hits I have on my website alone, I do not believe this is the case. So, my top columns for the year were, number one, the importance of the family restaurant. The popularity of this article was a pleasant surprise for me. In it, I described the role the family restaurant plays in our lives. I heard from a few restaurant owners who appreciated the piece. Number two, Penny for Pinellas faces uphill battle. Even though it was an off year politically, there was one issue commanding the attention of voters in my neck of the woods. Renewal of the Penny for Pinellas tax, which was slipped past the voters due to low turnout. Number three, rebuilding loyalty, which discussed why loyalty is an important part of our lives and why we should maintain it. Number four, the liberal playbook, describing the tools used by the left as they rearm themselves for the midterm elections. Number five, where are the adults? Written as the resistance movement heated up. Number six, how liberals control the media. This was one of my many pieces I wrote regarding the mainstream media. Number seven, the differences between left and right, which discussed the differences in codes of conduct. Number eight, what the March on Washington was all about, which is more on the resistance movement. And number nine, why the left hates Donald Trump, an older piece I wrote which gained ground again. Remarkably, there were two older pieces that were frequently read this past year. First, there was the Five Elements of Mass Production, which was written in 2013. This is a textbook explanation of the components of manufacturing and why they are necessary. The popularity of the piece suggests to me it is being referenced in school programs. And the second one was, How Did Our Moral Values Change?, which was another piece from 2013. I was pleased to see it resurface as morality is a favorite subject of mine. I will be on sabbatical for a while until I am ready to get back in the saddle. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, everyone. Friends, keep the faith. This is Tim Bryce in Palm Harbor, Florida. Follow me on the internet at timbryce.com.